This is Janine Schultz with the Chicago Tribune. We're backstage at Lollapalooza with Stephen Jenkins from Third Eye Blind. Well, you brought up your new song, Cop versus Phone Girl.
Yeah.
And you tweeted, and I wasn't there, I apologize, but you played it for the first time live today.
Yeah, we debuted it today at Lollapalooza in front of 70,000 people, and it was like quite the moment for us. It was really a moment for us. We had like, I think today at Lollapalooza was one of Third Eye Blind's like, I think it was probably one of the best festival performances we've ever had.
And I want to say, I mean, people that don't know, if they haven't heard the song yet, yet, it's about Black Lives Matter and this very specific incident in South Carolina.
That's right.
And so, you know, the audience
Springfield High School in South Carolina, a child, and I mean she was a 16-year-old girl, was subjected to an assault by an overly aggressive cop. And it was caught on cell phone by multiple students in the class because those students knew and therefore their psyches took for granted that they lived in a school where the people who were supposed to protect them could with impunity physically abuse them. That's why they took out their cameras. That's why the whole thing was so insane to me. And it got its little 2 minutes of fame and then nothing happened about it. And it stuck with me because for so many reasons, but it stuck with me and it left this emotional dent in me, and I fill up those dents with music, and that's how the song came about.
And I guess, and I want to talk about at the RNC, you know, you had a viral moment because you played this
charity,
a total viral moment. You played this charity concert and you know, kind of called out, you know, raise your hand who believes in science, and you know, some people were on Twitter were excited about that. Other people at that concert, it went viral because there's a lot of booing in the audience.
That's the funniest thing I've ever seen at a show. When I said, raise your hand if you believe in science, and like half the audience booed. Boo. Boo science. No. It was such an honest moment. I was like, yeah, there you go.
But the crazy thing is, a couple of days ago at the Democratic National Convention, Hillary Clinton's giving her speech on Thursday, and she says, I believe in science.
I know, and I got credit for that line. It's like, The Hill and all these other magazines said, aha. And she just like, you know, she just clapped it at Stephen Jenkins. I love it. I hope she did.
I mean, were you at home watching it going, wait a minute.
I was like at home and my like Twitter and my phone like blew up when that happened. It just blew up. And so I thought
it was great. She hasn't called you to give you credit for it yet.
She has not, and I don't claim a copyright on science, and I'm glad that she said it. Yeah.
Finally, talking about Lollapalooza, you guys have played a lot of festivals this summer, and we were talking off camera before this set at Lollapalooza, you know, it was kind of bursting at the seams. There were tons of people kind of gathering toward the stage to see you.
And
you guys have been around, you guys have been putting out music, so it's not like, oh, you're only a 90s band. We should only know you from, you know, the hits or whatever. But is there ever a moment where you're, you know, standing in 2016 at a giant festival like this, looking at all those people going, what are we doing here? How did we get here in 2016?
No, not at all. No, I don't have that feeling at all. We've always been kind of a cult band, and we've always had, a sense of identity and collective idealism, and we've always been sort of in that underground space, and most of our audience wasn't even around for like any MTV stuff.
That's what I'm saying. These people at this show, it's like they were babies in the 90s, and so it has progressed further than that.
They were babies, or they weren't born. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. I mean, you're being kind. Yeah, no.
Or maybe I'm just trying to think that I'm trying to pretend I'm still young. Like
you are. You got great skin. You see out there our audience are 17 to 30-year-olds, and I love that. I love it that they keep our music alive. I love it that when we go out and we play songs from our current album Dopamine, that you can see those rhythms and those lyrics ingrained in them, and that it gives them some kind of, it gives their like identity some kind of energy. To me, that's just amazing. I love it.
Awesome. Thank you so much for joining us.
Hey, thanks for having me. I like your paper.
Thank you.
Yeah.